Good morning, students. Hope you all are fine. Today, I will start with a poem, Amanda, from your First Flight book. This poem has been written by Robin Kleen. And in this poem, the poet has expressed the views of a little girl whose name is Amanda. Amanda is always pointed out by her mother because, according to her mother, she keeps making mistakes. And her mother feels that these mistakes are those mistakes which are not considered to be a code of conduct. And those code of conduct have been laid by the society. That is, the society we live in has a list of do's and don'ts. Like, you all also must have faced certain situations wherein you would have felt that what I am doing is right. Main jo kar raha hu ya main jo kar rahi hu wo sahi hai. But mere parents ko wo sahi kyun nahi lagta hai? To aapke parents ko wo sahi isiliye nahi lagta hai because according to them that is not what is acceptable in the society. Like, sometimes girls, they do question this thing to their parents that my brother can roam out at night, wo akele ja sakta hai, main kyun nahi ja sakti? Because the society does not accept these things. And because we are a social animal, hum log sab ek social animal hain, to hum logon ko society ke ye norms ko, ye code of conduct ko follow karna padta hai. Okay, so the poem basically talks about a girl whose name is Amanda. And her mother, that is Amanda's mother, she always points out some of the other mistake in her child. Sometimes she's stopped because she bites her nails. Sometimes her mother asks her that you must sit straight because she feels that Amanda is very lazy. And whenever she's pointed out for any mistake of hers, she feels that she is being constantly poked by her mother, so she gets troubled. So she tries to escape. Of course, she cannot run away from her home, and we must not do that. So what she does, she starts imagining herself. She goes into a dreamland. Sometimes she wants to become a mermaid. Sometimes she wants to become a character of a fairy tale, so that she can escape all these nagging. So whenever we come across a problem, we want to avoid that problem. Now, Amanda is a little girl. She cannot speak loudly when her mother is scolding her. So what she does, she goes into a dreamland. She wants to escape. Wo bhag jana chahti hai. To wo kahan bhagegi? To wo apne ek sapnon ki duniya mein chali jati hai, and she finds happiness over there. Ki agar main mermaid hoti to main akele, mermaid is a jalpari. Agar main mermaid hoti to main akele enjoy karti. अगर मैं वो फेरी टेल का एक कैरेक्टर होती तो मैं उस स्टार में अकेले रहती. सो दीज आर द मैकेनिज्म्स दैट शी अप्लाई टू मेक हरसेल्फ हैप्पी. सो नाउ आई विल स्टार्ट विद द एग्जैक्ट पोएम. डोंट बाइट योर नेल्स अमांडा. डोंट हंच योर शोल्डर्स अमांडा. स्टॉप दैट स्लाउचिंग एंड सिट अप स्ट्रेट अमांडा. नाउ इन द ब्रैकेट्स व्हाट यू सी दैट इज, सो डोंट बाइट योर नेल्स, दीज लाइन्स are being spoken by Amanda's mother, and whatever there is in bracket, that is being thought by Amanda. So please see the difference. Amanda is not speaking all these lines. She is thinking. There is a languid emerald sea where the sole inhabitant is me, a mermaid drifting blissfully. So now, if you pay attention, don't bite your nails, don't hunch your shoulders. When there is a repetition of the same word in the continuity, in the different lines, that repetition is called as anaphora. Okay, so keep it in mind. Hunch here means bend. Jhukna is to bend. Slouching here means to sit in a lazy manner. Jab hum bahut lazy manner mein aise apni पूरी बैक को झुका के सोते हैं या बैठते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज टू स्लाउच. मेनी अ टाइम्स योर टीचर ऑल्सो टेल आस्क यू सिट स्ट्रेट, दैट इज नो वे टू सिट. डोंट स्लाउच, डोंट स्टूप. ओके, लैंग्विड मीन्स रेस्टलेस, बहुत रिलैक्स्ड होके काम करना. ओके, एमरल्ड, एमरल्ड इज अ स्टोन दैट इज सी ग्रीन इन कलर. इनहेबिटेंट, इनहेबिटेंट का मतलब होता है कहीं रिसाइड करना. ओके, हम जहाँ रहते हैं, लाइक इफ़ यू लिव इन डाल्टनगंज, यू आर द इनहेबिटेंट ऑफ डाल्टनगंज. ड्रिफ्टिंग, ड्रिफ्टिंग मीन्स बीइंग कैरिड अवे स्लोली बाय द वॉटर. एंड ब्लिसफुली मीन्स हैप्पी. ओके, सो नाउ आई एक्सप्लेन यू द लाइन्स. द पोएट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट अमांडा हु इज़ अ लिटिल गर्ल एंड शी इज ऑलवेज पॉइंटेड आउट बाय हर मदर बिकॉज शी कीप्स मेकिंग मिस्टेक्स. सो द पोएम स्टार्ट्स एज इन द मदर इज पॉइंटिंग आउट अमांडा बिकॉज शी इज बाइटिंग हर नेल्स विच अकॉर्डिंग टू हर इज अ बैड हैबिट. एंड एनी वेज बाइटिंग नेल्स इज अ बैड हैबिट. जितनी भी डर्ट होती है हमारे नेल्स में वो हमारे मुँह में चली जाती है. सो शी सेज डोंट बाइट योर नेल्स अमांडा, डोंट हंच योर शोल्डर्स अमांडा. नेक्स्ट हर मदर आस्क्स हर टू सिट स्ट्रेट विदाउट बेंडिंग हर शोल्डर्स बिकॉज शी फील्स दैट अमांडा इज इन अ हैबिट ऑफ बेंडिंग हर शोल्डर्स एंड सिटिंग इन अ लेजी मैनर. सो हर मदर हियर वॉन्ट्स हर टू सिट इरेक्ट, टू सिट स्ट्रेट. सो एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम when her mother is scolding her, she wants to escape of this problem. Of course, no one likes to be scolded. So at this point of time, when she is being scolded, she imagines herself to be in a deep sea which is green in color. And she says that I want to be the only resident, that is sole resident. Sole matlab hota hai akele. So she wants to live there alone. She wants to एस्केप. तो वो एस्केप करके कहाँ जाना चाहती है? एक ब्यूटिफुल ग्रीन सी में जाना चाहती है. सो शी स्टार्ट्स इमेजिनिंग हर सेल्फ एज अ मरमेड. मरमेड हम बोलते हैं जलपरी को. सो शी इमेजिन्स हर सेल्फ दैट शी इज़ अ मरमेड जो एक डीप ग्रीन सी में अकेले रह रही है. एंड देयर फॉर शी इज़ लीडिंग हर लाइफ इन अ वेरी रिलैक्सिंग वे. शी सेज दैट आई वॉन्ट टू बी कैरिड अवे, दैट इज ड्रिफ्टिंग बाय द करेंट ऑफ वॉटर. एंड आई वॉन्ट to be very happy because I will enjoy the environment there and there would be no one to come and scold. Okay, so I have already talked about the literary device, that is anaphora. If you see this emerald sea, now what is this? This is metaphor, because this use of word emerald sea for green color, that is sea is being compared to emerald, that is a stone which is green in color. Then the words Amanda are being repeated. So now what is this? This is repetition. And here she has talked about mermaid. So mermaid is an imaginary creature. So aise literary device ko hum bolte hain allusion, allusion. Now did you finish your homework, Amanda? Did you tidy your room, Amanda? I thought I told you to clean your shoes, Amanda. Now again, these lines are being spoken by Amanda's mother, and whatever is there in the bracket, that is being thought, not spoken by Amanda. Now orphan is a child whose parents are dead. And here if you see, Amanda is thinking of I am an orphan roaming the street. I pattern soft dust with my hushed bare feet. The silence is golden. The freedom is sweet. Now here, the poet says that Amanda's mother has again started and she is inquiring her that whether you have completed your homework or not. And then she looks around and she sees that Amanda's room is very dirty. Then she asks her that why you have not cleaned your room. And moreover, she also asks her that I asked you to clean your shoes as well. Why haven't you done that? So one thing that we can see here is that the mother is constantly nagging about something or the other. Sometimes she asks her, don't bite nails, then sit erect, why you have not completed your homework, why your room is dirty, why your shoes. So she keeps on nagging continuously. So Amanda gets perturbed. She gets disturbed. And then she wants to move out of all these things. Then she starts imagining herself to be an orphan who is roaming in the street. This means that
she has gone to a level. Of course, it is not acceptable. No child would go to a level where he or she starts imagining that he or she should be an orphan. But think of the condition, or think of the state of the mind that Amanda is going through, that she starts imagining that if she would have been without parents, she would have been free. She could have enjoyed her freedom. So sometimes children, they start thinking at their extreme. कि अगर मेरे मम्मी पापा ही नहीं होते तो वाओ कितना मज़ा आता, फ्रीडम मिलता. बट डू यू नो यू वुड नॉट बी कॉम्पिटेंट इनफ टू इन्जॉय दैट फ्रीडम. आज आप वो फ्रीडम इसलिए इन्जॉय कर पाते हैं, आप बाहर निकलते हैं, आपके पास बाइक है, आप अच्छे कपड़े पहनते हैं. ये सब किसकी वजह से है? ये सब है बिकॉज यू आर ब्लेस्ड, यू हैव पेरेंट्स. एनीवेज, सो अमांडा स्टार्ट्स इमेजिनिंग दैट इफ शी वुड हैव बीन विदाउट पेरेंट्स, तो शी वुड हैव वॉक्ड फ्रीली इन द streets, and she would have gone to the beach side and she would have drawn patterns or designs on the dust with her bare feet, that is without any shoes or slippers. So what we see here, that her mother only wants her to keep everything neat and clean. She only wants her to complete her homework, but Amanda doesn't want to do all these things, and therefore she is so fed up of this continuous nagging that she feels ki chup rehna hi acha hai. There is a very famous proverb, silence is golden. So she is quiet, but she also agrees that freedom is sweet, and she feels that meri mummy jab tak hai tab tak kabhi main ye freedom enjoy nahi kar sakti hu. So when does she feel free? She feels free when her mother, she would stop nagging, or she would stop constantly pointing out her mistakes. Okay, so again, if you see, did and did, this is repeated. So I have already told you, repetition of a word at the start of two or more lines, that is called as anaphora. Now here you see, what did we find here? Did is repeated. In the previous one, don't was repeated. So this repetition is called as anaphora. Here, freedom is sweet. Now this is what? Freedom is said to be sweet in taste. Freedom is not an edible item. We can't eat it. We can just feel it. So here, what is this? This is metaphor. We are comparing it to another thing. Silence is golden. Again, this is a metaphor. Silence is said to be glorious, like golden color. Don't eat that chocolate, Amanda. Remember your acne, Amanda. Will you please look at me when I'm speaking to you, Amanda? I am Rapunzel. I have not a care. Life in a tower is tranquil and rare. I will certainly never let down my bright hair. Now, here you see, again her mother has started nagging. Acne means what? Girls must be knowing this very well, because we hate it. एक्ने का मतलब होता है पिंपल्स, जो हमारे फेस पे छोटे छोटे दाने हो जाते हैं, एंड ऑफकोर्स इट डजेंट लुक गुड, और गर्ल्स बहुत परेशान हो जाती हैं कि इसको कैसे ठीक किया जाए. दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्ने. रैपन्ज़ल इज अ कैरेक्टर ऑफ अ फेरी टेल. शी इज अ कैरेक्टर ऑफ अ फेरी टेल. शी हैड लवली ब्यूटिफुल लस्ट्रस लॉन्ग हेयर. ओके, एंड ट्रैंक्विल हियर मीन्स काम एंड क्वाइट, एंड समथिंग विच इज अनकॉमन इज रेयर. So now, this poem, again, if you see in this poem, Amanda's mother has again started nagging, and she is asking Amanda not to eat chocolates, because of course it would spoil her teeth. Even our mother, your mother also would be doing the same thing. Zyada toffee mat khaiye beta, aapke teeth kharab ho jayenge. To wo aapke bhale ke liye bol rahi hai. Unke teeth thodi na kharab honge, teeth to aapke kharab honge. So Amanda's mother is also doing the same thing, and she is also saying one more thing, that too much of sweet would lead to acne on your face. Aap bahut zyada meetha khaiyega to aapke muh pe pimples nikal aayenge. Then she scolds her for not paying attention to what her mother is saying, because Amanda never looks straight. Wo idhar udhar dekhti rehti hai, wo apni mummy ke instructions ko ignore karti hai. Aisa aap log bhi karte hain, you ignore the instruction. But have you ever thought that why our parents do this? Why our teachers do this? उन्हें मज़ा आता है? No, they want you to be the best of the child. So at this point, now again she wants to escape. So वो escape करना चाहती है, तो अब वो क्या सोच रही है? She starts imagining herself to be Rapunzel. So Rapunzel is a character from a fairy tale. And she was very beautiful. She had beautiful long hair. और उसको एक witch ने, एक चुड़ैल ने capture करके एक बहुत huge tower में रखा था. और वो जो witch थी, वो tower climb भी करती थी with the help of the long hair of Rapunzel. जब वो window से बाहर अपने बाल करती थी, तो वो बाल वो tower के नीचे तक, मतलब floor तक touch करता था. Her hair was so long. So now Amanda wants to be Rapunzel. Because she feels कि मैं उस स्टार में अकेले रहूँगी तो मैं अपनी पीस को enjoy कर पाऊँगी. I want to live a tranquil life. मुझे एक peaceful life चाहिए, एक uncommon life चाहिए. ये जैसी life हर student, हर children जी रहा है ना, जिसमें वो अपने parents से डांट खाते हैं, मुझे वैसी life बिल्कुल नहीं चाहिए. Because she wants to live free. उसे freedom चाहिए. I want to live in a peaceful environment. So she also confirms, वो ये भी कहती है कि वो अपने बाल भी कभी नीचे नहीं गिराएगी, क्योंकि Rapunzel विंडो से अपने बाल बाहर करती थी. She says, I will never let down my hair, कि कोई भी मेरे हेयर को पकड़ के ऊपर ना आ सके. So she has reached a stage where she wants to live all alone because she is fed up of the constant nagging by her mother. Stop that sulking at once, Amanda. You are always so moody, Amanda. Anyone would think that I nagged at you, Amanda. Now here, sulking means to be in a bad mood. और moody का मतलब होता है जिनके बहुत mood swings होते हैं. आप कभी खुश हैं, कभी अचानक से sad हो गए. मतलब एक unstable mood होता है. और nagging का मतलब constantly किसी को harass करते रहना. कभी तुम्हारी ये ख़राब, तुम्हारा वो ख़राब. तो कोई आदमी जो continuously complain करता है ना, हम उसे बोलते हैं कि ये आदमी बहुत nag करता है. तो अमांडा की मदर क्या कर रही है? कंटिन्यूसली नैग कर रही है. नाउ अमांडाज मदर इज वार्निंग हर दैट नाउ अ डेज यू हैव स्टार्टेड बिहेविंग इन अ वेरी डिफरेंट मैनर. सो शी आस्क्स हर टू स्टॉप बीइंग इन अ बैड मूड एंड शी आल्सो ब्लेम्स हर कि तुम्हारा मूड बहुत अनस्टेबल है. एंड शी स्कोल्ड्स हर बाय सेइंग दैट इफ यू कीप बिहेविंग लाइक दिस, पीपल वुड थिंक दैट आई एम बीइंग, यू आर बीइंग हैरस्ड बाय मी. मैं तुम्हें बहुत हैरस करती हूँ. सो नाउ अ मदर इज गेटिंग एंग्री कि अगर तुम ऐसे मुंह बना के बैठी रहोगी और तुम इतनी मूडी होगी तो लोग क्या सोचेंगे? लोग यह सोचेंगे कि मैं, आई एम नॉट अ गुड मदर एंड आई कॉन्स्टेंटली हैरेस यू. सो हियर वॉट वी कैन से दैट अमांडा इज बीइंग पॉइंटेड आउट बाय हर मदर ऑन वेरी लिटिल थिंग्स, बट शी इज नॉट रिएक्टिंग टू दिस एट ऑल. बिकॉज इफ शी रिएक्ट्स टूवर्ड दिस by speaking something or by getting emotional, her mother would take this against her sense of pride और वो उसे और scold करेगी कि तुम्हारी हिम्मत कैसे हुई ऐसे बोलने की. तो वो क्या कर रही है? वो बहुत quiet हो गई है. Now even if she is quiet, her mother feels that now she is behaving in a very unstable manner. What would people think of me? So one thing that we could conclude is that yes, Amanda's mother is very dominating and at times Amanda is perturbed or she is disturbed by the way her mother is behaving. So at times the parents should also be a bit lenient towards their children. We should not pressurize them much. Hame bahut pressure nahi dalna chahiye un pe. We should try to make them comfortable so that they themselves realize that what is the code of conduct. सो इट इज़ अ टू वे प्रोसेस. पेरेंट्स को भी सोचना चाहिए और बच्चों को भी सोचना चाहिए कि हमारे पेरेंट्स किसके लिए बोलते हैं. वो हमारे ही भले के लिए बोलते हैं. ओके, सो नाउ इफ यू सी हियर, स्टॉप सल्किंग. दिस इज़ अ रेपिटिशन ऑफ द साउंड एस. सो नाउ रेपिटिशन ऑफ द साउंड इज कॉल्ड एज ऑलिटरेशन. अगैन रेपिटिशन ऑफ अमांडा, दिस इज लिटरेरी डिवाइस दैट इज रेपिटिशन. So I hope the poem is clear. So please go through it very carefully and you will be given certain questions. Try to answer those. Thank you, students. We'll meet again in the next lecture.